Right. We do face cam off and on at times, so I'm just gonna see how I feel. But there's more follow through. It's an evil playthrough, so we have to be a piece of shit. We have to. Where's Rima City? Where the hell's Rima City? Oh, Jesus. No, it's way south. Oh, God. I gotta travel, like, for fucking ever. What's the closest place I have? Enemies? What? Oh god, that's a stronger one. What kind of reason? No! That was ridiculous. I lost entirely too much health. That was stupid. Oh, did my game just freeze? Fuck! Well, let's try that again. Okay, well, I guess we get a second chance to not have fucked it up, though. Let's see if it crashes again. Come on! Stars, a fuckload of super mutants. Are you kidding me? That's so many. A fucking battle going on. Who is that? Those raiders? Who is that? My brother. Who in fucking hell? That's a secure shot. Oh, that's a break. No. Okay. Oh god. Oh, my head is fucked up. I have no stink packs. Any food or bullshit to eat? Oh, I got some fucking pork and beans, that's gonna help. Oof. Just need to get out of the strip. Let's go this way, away from where all this happened. Oh, jeez, what is this? Oh my god, I'm severely congested. No! Fuck you! I'm not part of this! Definitely not the different ones. Those are random raiders. I'm not gonna shoot. Shit. Okay, what if I follow the river? Dukov. Who the fuck's Dukov? He keep your weapons holstered to get shot. Was Dukov the dude that's banging two ladies? Yeah, Dukov's in the banging two ladies. Cherry and Fantasia. He's got himself
set up. Who the hell are you? Never mind. You need a drink. Cherry, I'm thirsty over here.
They're close.
Ha-ha! They're my party girls! I'm too much man for just one woman, so I need two! I wear them out every night.
He's a player!
Why should they bother getting dressed when I'm just going to take it off? Hey, watch your language, clown shoes. I don't pay them. They take care of me, so I take care of them. We'll rub each other wrong all night long. Help yourself, clown shoes. Grab one from the liquor cabinet. I never trust anyone without a drink in their hand. Of course,
hell yeah,
I
brother.
Never trust one that does either.
Can I have another drink? Oh, shit. Oh, I don't want to get... Oh, is there a special interactive if I drink? Hold on, I'm gonna have another drink.
Sure, didn't I?
Aw.
Eating, drinking, farting, and screwing! Out here, nobody bothers me. I can do whatever I like to whoever I want.
Hell yeah, brother. I mean, it's post-apocalypse. Like, dude on protection and laser down, I mean... Night's winds. I better go before I get a headache. You know what? Another drink.
Sure. You need to drink more. Ha ha!
Drink more. Do these ladies talk or are you not allowed to?
Hi there, fella. I'm Fantasia. Can I help you? Dookie doesn't like me to wear a lot. He says it slows things down. He's all right. He can be a real fun guy. But he sure knows how to wear a girl out. Most of all, I'm safe here. I wouldn't pull out a weapon, even just to show him. He gets kind of paranoid about that. Don't get in a shooting match with him. He's really good.
He's got a sweet... I mean, he technically
sweet for
does.
Him, maybe.
In the post-apocalypse, this is the best, like, a
He's
party like this
gun,
could ask
knows
for.
Knows where to get booze. It's, well... It's Dukov's place. He lives here. Pretty much, he just does a lot of drinking and partying.
Again, best possible outcome of the apocalypse. You drink and party and fuck all the time and you're still alive? That is the best possible outcome. Dukov,
hey,
you poor.
This is Three Dog.
Cherry,
wow,
skin hammered to get hammered later.
Hi, sweetie. I'm Cherry. What can I do for you?
Why aren't you dressed?
Dukov likes to keep it hot. Ain't no need for nothing else. He's a lecherous old man. The only reason I put up with him and his needs is because I'm safe here. He tends to shoot first and ask questions later. Don't pull out a weapon near him. He's likely to shoot you. And he's
I feel like Fantasia's
really
more on board and likes Dukov more than you do. Admit it, you're just a whore. This is the asshole playthrough, you dirty whore.
Yours. It's not like I've got a lot of other options. The only survival skill I've got is the one I'm using here. Why the hell should I...
No!
Hey, it's my...
Hold on. I want to see what happens when that check passes.
What? Hi, sweetie.
We need to
I'm
find
Cherry.
Out what happens when that check passes.
What can I do for you?
Are there companions in this?
Dukov likes to keep it hot. Ain't no need for nothing else.
Okay, so what's the deal with Dukov?
He's a lecherous old man. The only reason I put up with him and his needs is because I'm safe here. He tends to shoot first and ask questions later. Don't pull out a weapon near him. He's likely to shoot you. And he's really good.
Admit it, you're just a filthy whore.
Up yours. It's not like I've got a lot of other options. The only survival skill I've got is the one
titties.
I'm using here.
Oh, my God. She's not wrong. I didn't catch her saying that last time.
Only if you take me to Rivet City. And don't think I'm going to give you the same privileges I give Dukov. You and I are sleeping separate.
Stole Dukov's whore. It's going to be a while before I go to Rivet City.
Let me pack my bags. Oh.
No, I just stole Dukov's whore. Let's go to Rivet City. She's legit just following me. I'm going there anyways. Let's do this. Bonus mission. She's just buck-ass naked in the wasteland. Are you kidding me? Alright, straight to Rivet City. This is going to be a pain in the fucking ass. I'm going to go backwards the whole way for reasons. Shit. Looks like we can't make it. Oh, it is. Ah, fuck. Why am I caught in a lip? What is she helping for? Damn it. How do I get back up there? What are you yelling help for, bitch? Get back here. Chit shot? She's running back to Dukov's? Is the AI tracking that? What's happening? Back here, you dirty whore. What are you doing? Now you're an irradiated whore. Okay, we're just gonna fight this kid. You raider, bitch. Oh, missed. Still don't have any healings. Shit. Double shit. I'm on drugs. No. Can I point damage? Wait, can I hit something from point blank range?
Unemployment is down, stocks are up, and the UN has just declared global peace forever. Now the real news.
I have 1 HP, what is this?
Ooh. Today's okay. Weather excessively violent with a chance of dismemberment. Tune in later for our 5-day forecast.
I guess it's gone now.
Thanks for listening, children.
This is
Free Dog.
Not hopeless. Keep calm the calamities out of your memories. Oh shit! Oh, why am I slow? What's happening? No. Oh, fuck. There's one. No. Stop shooting at me. Whore. Pick up a gun. Can I get any stuff?
Yeah.
Oh, I can tell how to follow my lead. Fucking follow requests in every game ever made. Escort missions. It's gonna work. Okay, it's gonna draw my sign if we do go some other direction. Okay, sure. Okay, the guy come to me. Shot in the head. Next one's gonna also come in. AP recharge. AP recharge. Kill shit, big guy.
Hey, everybody, this is
you beat your
shape
for me. Thank you, Stukov, badass the wasteland.
Psycho. James, the guy from the vault. And then I told you somebody else crawled out of there too. Right. Well, guess who came to visit old Three Dog at his luxurious studio in beautiful downtown DC? That's right, the other vault dweller. Now, you want to know if it gets better, don't you? Well, hell yes, it gets better. Turns out vault dweller number two was none other than James's kid. I know, I couldn't make this shit up. Okay, but now it gets kind of sad. You see, the kid is looking for his dad. Looking for James. See, James left Vault 101 without telling the kid why. Now, I've since learned that James is a scientist and is working on something big. Is that why he left the vault? Looks that way. So who knows, maybe James is going to save the world.
You're giving your house.
Can't think of a better cause than that. But James, if you're listening, your kid's out, man. And he misses you. So you might want to find him before he gets swallowed up and spit out.
And bitch, I'm going to swallow up and spit out the entire wasteland. The I'm the wanderer. Wait, no, I'm not. I'm the vault dweller. On the back. Which one is this one? The wanderer's in Vegas. I'm a badass. I will kill you motherfuckers.
And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, bringing you the truth, no matter how bad it hurts.
Oh, should have made me a cup of Super Mutant's ass and laugh about it. That's Victoria. Bitch, are you detecting me? You're sleeping! Hey. Oh, he's playing that too, isn't that guy? I can't say that. So, like, why would you broadcast in the wasteland? Like, I'm doing it off of my Pip-Boy as I walk around. sells per stick. It's per
stick.
Oh, that's fucking cool. Rivet City. Wait, I wonder what Dukov says after I take one of his horse. That other horse would have to work 50% harder. Oh god! Get down, whore! I'm an escort. Or an oh god, there's a bunch of supercars in this area. The super mutants, I remember this place. Oh god! Why are none of these so bad? Come on, just keep running. Pretend you don't see them. They're not real. They don't exist. How close are we? We made it. Oh! We're like halfway! Holy shit! Okay, that is progress. I'm taking that. 100% taking that. Okay, I'm gonna shuck. Two, so I'm gonna tear through any camps. Cool. Oh, did that one be fun? I've never seen that. Oh, blood pack. Cover. Explosives. Sweet. Oh, I have a stim pack. When did they pick that up? Definitely super mutant camp. Wait a second, hold on. Your name is Cherry, and you look like that chick from the Cherry 3000 movie? I never noticed that. That's post-apocalypse too. Robot whore.
Whatever. I've got
AI robot whore. Sentient AI robot whore. I'll shoot this on me. Hold on, don't shoot, just don't. Serpentine. Oh god, they have mines out. I did not catch that. Okay, where's the other one? Am I AP recharge? Hey, slow down. Machines. There we go. Where's the one? It's called a slug. Is that one wrong? I stepped on seniors.
Nothing here after all. I'm
out
of here.
I don't even need fats. I these fuckers in. Got a super mutant encampment here? Is that what to do? They're all dead. How is it hopeless? They were more than halfway there then. It's hopeless to get any good to do.
I'm tickled
Oh shit. Four bags. Oh, hey, what the hell?
Master of ceremonies.
Hello.
Yes, time for the news.
Probably bad things happen to you.
Kids, our old friend from Vault 101 is, get this, still alive. Yes, there is a god.
Untie her.
Here's your update on the Ranger of the Waste.
Wait, I should kill you. This is my evil playthrough.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Why did I save you? I'm supposed
to
be evil.
I thought I was dead for sure. Here. I managed to hide these supplies before they tied me up. You take them. It's the best I can do to thank you.
You'll need it more than I will. Oh, why did I do a good thing again? Stop being good, goddammit. I have to evil playthrough. God, no! I'm supposed to be evil. Bad karma. Come here so I can just kill them. I can't be evil. I need to get my small guns.
Sad.
Just regular
guns. The kid
up.
Is looking for his dad. Looking for James.
See, big guns. Is that like sniper rifle? It's a sniper rifle falling down.
Now I've since learned that James is a scientist and is working on something big. Is that why he left the vault? Looks that way. So who knows? Maybe James is going
to save
the world.
Get more money in caps. Actually, we're gonna crank this. I need to. I can get more ammo if I do this.
If you're listening, your kid's out, man, and he misses you. So you might want to find him before he gets swallowed up and spit out.
Ooh,
and for all
your
other cats out there listening, if you see the kid from Vault 101 out there, give him a
more ammunition. That's the one I want. Yes.
Wish him luck.
Yes. Okay.
Thanks for
buy
listening,
more. Or to find
children.
More.
There. This is $3.
No. You're back here. Make this easier for me to be evil. Beautiful. I'm an evil man. You had hope. You were free. That makes us more evil. And I shot you in the back. It's a quadruple evil. It's kind of there's fallout, but not crazy. This is a water treatment plant? I'm here already? Well, let's just beat the game, boys. Fuck it. Let's just go. Beat the game. Why am I walking so? It's really late. Pickles. Stop shooting at me. Fuck, another one. Oh, I knew Super Mutants was going to show it. I can't team it. Oh god, I'm almost out of Super Mutant bullets, too. It's probably gonna break soon. I'm paying attention to that. Shit, it is! I need this gun to survive! Son of a bitch. This one needs a suit. Oh, that's the gift shop we're gonna actually go into. Not another fucking enchantment. Wait, that's the same one! Oh my god, I went the wrong freaking direction going that way. Ugh. I don't even see enemy on radar. You got higher perception than me or something? Holy shit, I'm here! Fuck yeah! I keep surprising myself. I keep feeling like this will be harder to do, or I'm gonna get slowed down more. Some caps in there. I need to repair my combat shotgun. That poor guy that can't afford water. I don't even have enough to be water.
Can you help me? I need water. Purified water, please. I've been drinking this irradiated shit and I can't do it. I just throw it up now. I need purified water, please.
I don't have any.
But please.
I can help you. Another one comes.
Welcome to Rivet City. Please.
Yeah. Rivet City. Farmer, except for delivering right here?
Hold it right there. State your business in Rivet City.
Banging your mom.
On this boat, you sure as hell do. You don't. So I'll ask you again. And who might your father be? Dr. Lee. Well, then I guess you'd have to ask Dr. Lee from. Go on up, then. She's probably in the science lab. But keep your nose clean. You hear me? We're the safest, most secure city in the wasteland. Nothing can get in here without our say-so. Carry on, then.
Thank you.
Cheer. Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
You bitch.
Thank you. Yeah, yeah, you're my hero. Don't let it go to your head. Seriously, though. Thank you for getting me away from Duke.
Okay, I heard the serious apology. But let me go. Ooh, that's not what I wanted. Science lab. Lee, where is my father?
Look, Dr. Zimmer, we've been over this. We don't know about your runaway robot, and we don't care.
Since.
Dr. Lee is trying to save lives, and your constant interruptions are interfering with those efforts. Now please, stand aside.
I'm sure the good doctor's work with water purification is fascinating, but if you only knew what was at stake, the technology in that android...
What's at stake? you won't tell me what's at stake. Vagaries and secrecy. A robot, Zimmer, no matter how shiny the paint job. Now, please.
Ignorance and facetiousness.
Wake
That's
up,
all you people are good for.
It's me,
shiny paint job, indeed.
Bring all the music
you can't
and news
even imagine the Commonwealth's accomplishments.
Seems
you know,
got
if you're so smart,
help! Just listen to this. Now the latest on everyone's favorite,
like
Runfall 101. He's
you
out
like
there
this?
Serving as our protector, so show
you can't take me down and you got a pistol.
Listen to this.
I don't even have stats in punching.
Boy, children, you are going to love this. Okay, so I told you about James, the guy from the vault. And then I told you somebody else crawled out of there, too. Right. Well, guess who came to visit old Three Dog at his luxurious studio in beautiful downtown D.C.? That's right, the other vault dweller.
Not until you're confessed.
Well, yes, it gets better.
Forever.
Turns out Vault Dweller number 2 was none other than James's kid.
Yeah, I know.
I couldn't make this shit up.
Come for the camera.
Okay, but
shit, Armitage.
You see the kid is looking for James.
Embarrassing for you.
James left
the next taste.
Telling the kid why.
There's more with that game
now. I've since learned that James is a scientist and is working on something big. Is that why he left the vault?
You're crippling that arm. Who are you running to, boy?
Listen to this.
Not until I've spoken
now,
to
the latest
Lee.
On everyone's favorite run from Vault 101. He's out there serving as our protector,
science.
So show the kid
Suit
some respect.
Yourself.
Listen to this.
Yeah?
Boy, children, you are going to love this.
Look, some of us are trying to get work
so
done here.
James,
there have been anybody coming through here would have to talk to Dr. Lee.
Right.
The Weatherly Hotel is a good choice.
Well,
it's on the upper deck.
This luxurious studio.
You there. What are you, some kind of lab
right.
assistant?
The
no, you look a bit
dweller.
More weathered. Are you by any chance for hire?
Well, hell yes, it gets better. Turns out Vault Dweller number 2 was none other than James's kid.
To the point.
I
like that.
I
well, as it turns out, I've misplaced some very sensitive property. You'll be searching for an android. Do you know what an android is? No, I imagine you don't. All you know of robots are those buckets of bolts, those Mr. Handshakers and whatnot. Well, that's not all a robot can be. Not in the Commonwealth. I'm talking about artificial persons that think and feel and do what we program them to. And occasionally, they get confused and wander off.
So you might want to find him before he gets swallowed up and spit out. And for all you other cats out there listening, if you see the kid from Vault 101 out there, give him a pat on the back and wish him luck.
Nonsense! This is a machine we're talking about. Can you enslave a generator or a water purifier? Of course not. The same principle applies. But let's get back to your mission. You are to find this missing android. I've tracked him to somewhere here in the capital wasteland. He must have done something drastic, like facial surgery and a mind wipe, or else I would have found him by now. It will be no easy task. He may not even realize he's an android. Don't upset him by talking with him. Just come get me immediately. I'll handle it. I'm sorry, it slipped my mind. I'd be willing to share some of it with you. Just... Excellent! Here, listen to this message he sent me. He's mocking me. I swear, I'll make him pay for that.
Replicated man.
Like I said, I suspect he's had Search the offices of doctors or techies for android information. If he's come into contact with these people, there may be records. Start with Dr. Preston. He lives on this leaky boat. See if he knows anything. He's a doctor, after all. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm busy trying to ignore my surroundings. Maybe he didn't exactly wander off. Maybe he fled. Escaped captivity, as it were, if he began to misinterpret his situation. It's possible my android sought to forget his previous life. Wipe away all memory, all guilt. Trick himself into believing he really is human. So no, he may not be just an ordinary robot, but he's certainly not human, no matter how badly he wishes it so. I made
all right, the Institute bullshit right here.
By God, you're as annoying as you are clever. Very well. I'll tell you what you want to know, if it helps you locate my property. The duty of this particular unit was the hunting and capturing of other escaped androids. Yes, others have escaped.
Oh, Blade Runner.
Side effects of having such an advanced AI. Machines
replicated
start to
man's
think
Blade
for
Runner.
Themselves, fool themselves into believing they have rights. Ooh. And so, this particular android may have believed he'd done something wrong, immoral, and wanted to forget those deeds. Satisfied now? The Commonwealth itself is nothing but a war-ravaged quagmire of violence and despair. Inside the sealed environment of the Institute, however... But the Institute's affairs are none of your concern. Your undeveloped mind couldn't even begin to comprehend what we've accomplished.
Look, this is a restricted area. I'm tired of telling you people. It's you.
His dick ain't restricted,
bitch.
My heavens,
you look so much like him. You're James's son, aren't you? What are you doing here? You were too young to remember, and I suppose James never spoke of me. Typical. I am Dr. Madison Lee. I worked with your parents many years ago. Now I run the science lab here in Rivet City. It was all I had left. When your mother died, your father decided to leave with you. He abandoned our work. We had no choice but to do the same. You mean you haven't? I assumed he sent you here. For that matter, aren't you supposed to be in a vault? James said he left you there. Your father is no longer here, and I'd appreciate it if you didn't use that tone with me.
Bitch, I will use a wronger tone.
Well, I don't know where he is. The last I knew, he was going back to the old lab. Now, will you kindly leave? I have work. It's in the old Jefferson Memorial Building, northwest of here. Please, don't go after him. It was foolish of him to even think about going there alone.
Project Purity.
Look, I don't want to be harsh, but I have problems of my own.
Bitch, everybody does.
I don't
does.
Have the resources to support James's foolish endeavors or your chasing after. I suppose I can spare a few stim packs. It's not much.
Yes,
but you
need stim packs.
I suppose so. I worked with them for several years until your mother died and your father decided it was time to leave. What else do you? James, he was very driven, determined to change the world. Well, we all were back then, I suppose. He was focused on two things, really. Making Project Purity work, and your mother. When she died, I think he gave up. I know he wanted to keep you safe, but I think part of what he did was run away. But it seems that he never really was able to get over the idea. I'm frankly shocked that he waited all this time and wants to try again. Yes. Your mother was... Well, she was a good woman. A very dedicated scientist. Your father loved her very much. It was a shame that she died. She had been excited to meet you. Complications from childbirth. None of us were expecting it. We weren't as prepared as we could have been. You have to understand, we were struggling with scavenged, derelict equipment. We did everything we could. Yes, well, I'm sorry it wasn't enough. What? Well, I'm not sure what there is to tell. Your father and I, we worked together for a long time. I think we were really on to something. But then there were complications. The project was abandoned and your father disappeared. I returned here to Rivet City and established the lab you see before you now.
There have been more and more sightings of raiders over by Evergreen Mills. Smart money's on them having some kind of camp out that way.
This is the Rivet City Science Lab. It's taken many long years to put together, but we've done well for ourselves. Our work on portable fusion power and hydroponics are coming along quite nicely, if not quite according to schedule. Man doesn't have you looking for his pet android, does he? I've already told him to lay off it. He's distracting my entire team. Rivet City is one of the few bastions of civilization left in the land. We're working to rebuild our society, to make the world livable again.
All right. Android and father. I need to go to the marketplace. Hey, fuck you. Bonesaw.
I'm Flak. If you want a decent weapon, stop by Flak and Shrapnels. I'm sure that was just luck. You should upgrade. Check out our shop in the market. Try the Muddy Rudder. They don't ask too many questions down on the lower deck.
I have the caps for repair because I want to repair my...
Bye.
Find a merchant. You can buy and sell shit. Yo, let me out.
And yes, I can see you eyeing it.
Yeah. Did I just get locked in here? Anything goes.
When Rockefeller steals. Yeah, you need something? Bye.
How do I get out of here?
It was so noisy last night. I could hardly sleep. Maybe a quick fix is some sleep.
Charlie, it's a surprise. Why am I trapped in here? Are you serious? I'm just gonna get it. I think it's a wait till I play out.
Hello, mister.
What?
Good to see
you. Oh my god.
I'm not supposed to talk to strangers.
Good, smart child. Can you leave so I'm still in your face?
I'm gonna go play with James.
You do that.
I don't think you should mess with that.
I'm not trying to wait 2 more hours. How did this happen? No. Stealing from this man, he won't be able to feed his child. He'll go out of business. Just stopped. Evil! Shit, that's a lot. Sell it back then, yeah. Oh my god, wait, I'm gonna have to pick my way out of this place. I was trapped. I was kidnapped. I was illegally detained. Fuck you. May there be hotel?
Should tell me something about it.
Hello.
They call me Sister. Don't ask. Are you making fun of my name? It's a damn good thing for you this place is crawling with security. Otherwise, I'd kick your ass.
That's my...
You're bothering me. You... So
you
do I.
Kill this guy. Well, oh shit. Sister.
What was that?
Mr. Buckingham. Oh, he's upset. Oh, this is the Weatherby?
I serve Miss Vera Weatherly, proprietor of the Weatherly Hotel. Not that it's any of your business. This is the Weatherly Hotel. Please.
Yeah, I'm buying some things to you. I only got 110 caps.
Ooh, yes, please. Perfect. Yeah. Hell yes, Timberlands. I don't know if I've ever talked about sister care before. I've been to this weather series, please. Sister seems to have been doing it. Oh, this is sister's room. This is sister's stuff. Sister's a bitch.
Into each and every life, some rain has got
fuck you, sister.
But too much of that stuff.
Ooh, River City Market, okay. Vera Weatherly.
Charmed to meet you. I'm Vera Weatherly of the Weatherly Hotel.
You're charmed to meet me, just give me your back. 100%.
Well, I really shouldn't tell you, but have you heard about Polly Cantelli? He's addicted to chems. His poor wife Cindy is at her wit's end. You haven't heard? Angela has the hots for Diego. But since he's a priest, he's been putting her off. One of these days, she's just going to jump his bones. They say Mr. Lopez is losing it. He stands on the top of the bridge tower for hours at a time, just staring out over the city.
Men and ladies,
she's not very social. Stays in her lab in the stern. She's smart, though. Real smart. It's noisy, dark, and smelly. But we're safe here. No super mutants or raiders. And maybe Dr. Lee will find a way to get clean water for us.
Have you guys and gals ever seen a tree? No, no, no. Not those shriveled black things. I'm talking real trees. Brown bark, green leaves, photosynthesis, all that good
cheery
stuff.
Yeah, yeah, you're
now,
my
what
hero.
If I
don't let it go to your head.
Powerful.
Put your clothes now.
Wow, wow, wow.
Hey, not soaking Duke off anymore.
Welcome to Flak and Shrapnel. Decided to check out the
veritable oasis of green.
Here, I'm packing, and most of the rest of these guys are packing. Not to mention, yeah, he's totally strung out. That's gonna. Need to do.
Thanks for listening, children. This is
Free okay.
Dog. When you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, we're Radio Free Wasteland.
We got my ammo
here for you. And now,
so I almost want to sell these mines. I got 20 more in storage. Let the sun off. Anything. So one of these assault rifles. Shit, damage resistance. She has the steam pack stockpile. What? 300 caps, yes please. I'm gonna buy a shit ton of stuff with this guy. Fat man? Oh, wait. It's only 172 for a fat man? Oh, I'm so tempted. Isn't combat armor the best? I think it is. Shit. What's It's gonna be way better than what I have now. Damn it, okay, where is... Oh, I did sell them. 32 caliber, that's for the rifle, the hunting rifle. I got cleaned out now, shit. Stim packs. Okay. Oh wait, no, I do have more fragments to sell. Yes. Do just accept. Then we can purchase some rounds. Yes. No, shit. I need him to repair my shits.
Give me a shout if you need anything else.
I'm a shotgun. Oh, thank Christ.
If you...
Oh my God. Yes, I'm stockpiled.
Hey, good looking. How come you haven't bought me a drink yet?
I think it's your receding, balding hairline and small titties.
Now that's what I like in a man. Enough caps to buy a lady a drink. You're lost, sugar. Come and see me again.
Buy
a girl a drink, sailor? Tightwad? No, wait, I didn't mean that. Please, mister, just one drink? You're lost, sugar.
Officer, no, if you see anything out of the ordinary.
Dang, I need more caps. I've never interacted with your Confederable Jack.
Welcome to Gary's Galley. Can I take your order? It's named after my dad. He's a great cook. You mean like hitting on? No. Most of them are polite. Even the ones like Diego that I'd want to flirt with seem to ignore me. Well, one of us is. Sometimes it seems like... Especially if he is a priest with a thick skull. Well, I'm not giving up. I just know we're made for each other.
Wasteland psycho lady.
Thank you for coming to Gary's...
I thought she tried bribing me to get him in love with her. I thought there was a whole scheme.
Hey.
I thought she was a psycho. Renuka. Yes.
If you want a gun.
Who are you, Shrapnel?
They call me Shrapnel. I run this place. Got the best damn armament you'll ever see. Ain't seen many of those around lately. What you look?
Hell yeah, brother. Shit, I ain't got nothing. I just did my business. I think I might do that, actually. Shrapnel, fat man. Oh, I got rid of it anyways. Shit. Right. 10 millimeter, 5.56. That's most important ammo to me. I even got 5 caps. Shit.
Thanks. Let's have.
Where's the drink lady?
Ted Strayer. Ted Strayer. You can chill with. Later, dude.
You're the coolest fucker in this whole game.
Whoa. What's the. Later, dude.
Coolest dude in the whole fucking game. That guy's a fucking Chad.
Welcome to the Weatherly Hotel.
You just wanna chill with me, bro? Hell yeah. Later, dude. Fucking Giga Chad.
Is there a problem? Bannon and Dr. Lee and I all meet on Monday mornings to talk about citywide issues. It's pretty informal. The council doesn't have much real power. She's one of the members of the council. Runs the science lab here. Don't bother her unless it's important. Her lab is in the stern end of the ship.
Where's the chick who likes her hooch? Where'd she go?
Buy a girl a drink, sailor? Now that's what I like in a man. It's normal, but we're safe here. No super mutants or raiders, and maybe Dr. Lee will find a way to get clean water for us. Your lot. Buy a girl a drink, sailor? Now that's. Buy a girl a drink, sailor? Whoa. Why is the room spinning?
Oh, shit.
You're nice. I can tell you a secret. I'm drunk. No, that's not the secret. I have another secret. I know where Belle keeps her stash. But she doesn't know I know. She keeps it under her bed. Real original, huh? I think I need to puke. Buy a girl a drink, sailor?
Oh, yeah.
Now that's what I like. Buy a girl a drink, sailor? Now that's what I like in a man. Buy a girl a drink, sailor? Now that's what I like in a man. Enough caps to buy a lady.
As I speak, the Brotherhood is working with Ribbon.
Buy a girl a drink, sailor?
She'll do the summer. Now that's what happens. I like. Maybe nothing, but we're gonna find out.
Buy a girl a drink, sailor? Now that's what I like.
Until next time.
Buy a girl a drink, sailor?
I don't think it does anything.
Now that's what I like in a man.
Just kill her with alcohol.
Enough caps to buy a li- Buy a girl a drink, sailor? Now that's what I- Buy a girl a drink, sailor?
Shit.
Now that's what I like in a man.
I don't think it does anything. Oh, Trini,
yes.
Get drunker.
Good to see you.
Buy a girl a drink, sailor? Now that.
Okay, bye. Gary Staley.
I'm Gary. Gary Staley. If you ever get hungry, stop by Gary's galley.
It's even edible.
Why, you. I mean. Of course, it's edible. You should come by and try the Meyerlurk cakes. They're my specialty. Yeah, I know. Thank God he's a priest. At least I know nothing's going on between them. Father Clifford would kick him out of the priesthood if he ever found out. Yeah, he comes by every night around closing time and tries to get Cindy to let him close up. Thank God she's smarter than that. Bye.
Okay. So it's an
Hey there.
There's nothing in here. There's nothing in here. Look, 61% of fucking broke. Twice 60. Evil. No, three. How is it 61%? I don't feel like that percentage is accurate when it failed three times in a row. So, they're sleeping. Can't be detecting me. Holy shit, this dude is a man. Can I do this guy and take his stuff? Come here, buddy.
Who are you? Got any psycho? I could. I run the chem shop, but I'm broke and can't buy chems. Thanks, man. It's a place to live, safe from raiders. With Dr. Lee on our side, maybe we can even begin to. Make it quick, will ya? I'm coming down and I got. Thanks, man. Make it quick, will ya? I'm coming down and I gotta get my fix. Thanks, man. I really. Make it quick, will ya? I'm coming down and I gotta get my fix. Thanks, man. I really need this fix. Make it quick, will ya? I'm coming down and I gotta get my fix. Thanks, man. I really need this fix. Make it quick, will ya? I'm coming down and I gotta get my fix. That's what Cindy says too, but I got the itch. Make it quick, will ya? I'm coming down and I gotta get.
Oh.
My wife, Cindy, she's always watching the inventory.
Another shower star into each life, some rain must fall. The dream of cheers for
into each life, some rain must fall. But too much is.
Beautiful. Not super evil. Then we could feed him his own drugs.
Never mind.
I heard. Did he just OD? Oh, he did OD. Wait, did somebody stab him?
But too much of that stuff is falling into my.
Oh my god, he OD'd hard as fuck. Oops. Just fed him with shit though. I just killed that dude. Evil!
I'm on duty. Make it quick. Oh, if someone took your stuff, go get it back. Otherwise.
Okay, that helps. Okay, okay. Where is that guy's wife? I couldn't tell where he's from. She's gonna be
Potomac attire. Welcome to Potomac attire. I am Bannon. I carry Between you and me, keeping out the riffraff is good for business.
Oh, here, here.
Dr. Lee, Chief Harkness, and I are all on the council. We meet every Monday morning.
He's the scientist. You're looking at the security guard. Is your job just to be an asshole?
Seagrave Holmes. A threat? No, of course not. Well, maybe. He wants to replace me on the council. He's a shady character. I just can't prove it. Now, if someone were to find something incriminating in his room, well, let's just say I would be very appreciative.
I would be very appreciative.
Disgusting, isn't it? Someone should talk to that boy. He has no business hanging around that tramp if he's going to be a priest. Straight?
I don't want to do your crap. Quick fix. Hey, Cindy.
This is a quick fix.
How's it going,
that's
Cindy?
The name of the shop. My name is Cindy. Cindy Cantelli.
No, she doesn't.
No, no, no. I would never do that. Polly did. Sample it, I mean. He's dead now. Thank God.
Oh, okay. She's happy he died? And she already knows.
The poor dear. I wish there was something I could do to help her. That boy ought to just give her a tumble. It would be good for both of them. The Muddy Rudder. Bell waters down the liquor, but it's cheap. It's on the lower deck. Nice to see you again. I'm sure.
It's like he's dead, thank God. She's just happy he died. What even?
Hello.
I'm gonna go back to Dukoff and see if he's pissed or take his meals. Cherry 3000, you found your new home! Sent in AI sex doll, you're free!
Hey, nifty America. It's me, your president. John Hancock. Gotcha! Three dog here. How's everyone doing? What rhymes with shoes and often gives you the blues? That's right. It's time for the cashews.
I do the repairs around here, so if you see something that needs fixing, let me know.
News. I've been getting more and more reports of these mercenary maniacs from Talon Company, especially in the downtown DC area. If you see these hombres, steer clear. Whatever you have, they want, and they're not really into asking politely. Word is, these guys take all the contracts the other mercs won't. In short, there's nothing they won't do. So be careful out there. Thanks for listening, children. This is Three Dog. Ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you. And now, some music. How about some easy living from everyone's favorite songstress, Billie Holiday?
Everything looks okay here.
That was so sad. I need to get off this boat. Oh, but who's the synth? We need to find the synth. What's your good sentence?
Yes?
Are you the synth?
Janice Kaplinski, chief botanist. What do you need? I did see a man talking to Dr. Lee, but I really shouldn't be discussing it. She's already in a bad mood. I'd hate to make it worse. You should probably just talk to her about it. Other than him being an egotistical, arrogant, condescending pain in the ass, nothing. He's from the Commonwealth. He's come looking for some special robot. I must admit I'm rather curious, but I have other work to do.
You don't look too good. You're wounded. Let me bandage that.
Dang. 40%? That's so low. What's into speech crap? I need to do missions going on. Oh, also. Wait a second. Maybe you have a record of it. Four out of nine. R, G, and R, so receiving maybe? No, it would be R, E, so it's not receiving. Accepting, torture, happening, direction, turning. And the release. It's gotta be release. Why is that a nine? What? How? So, what? I don't want to lock myself out of this room. I need this. I'll just cover it every time. Get sort of the 99G. Not all my skills are just too low. Holy shit, convicted, conducted. Convicted, conducted, convinced? Are you fucking kidding me? Assisted. I'm not good at this. Absorbing. No. No. So is it anything? No. Okay, so it's no range. Fuck. That's just fucking stupid.
instinct, increased, convinced, increased. So it's not even PD, what? Oh my god, finally. This applies to everyone. Life's worth living. When nature's given happiness to everyone. So let's go, Sonny.
Ready for the Capital Wasteland's latest news? Me neither, but it's that time again. According to reports from the ever so hoity-toity Tenpenny Tower, a group of displaced ghouls have been trying to gain entrance. Ah, but Lush at Large, Alistair Tenpenny says, no zombies, no how. Come on, Al, cut the ghoulies a break. If they've got the caps and you've got the space, it's a win-win, right? What do you say? Thanks for listening, children. This is Three Dog, ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you. And now, some music.
Sick of damn thing about...
You're wounded. Let me be- Sorry. Yes, that's locked. And yes, I can see you. I.
Maybe. Good to see you.
I'm Diego. The
Saint. She is now the patron saint of lost children for the faithful everywhere. You really should come to church on Sunday mornings. The sermon will be all about Saint Monica. Oh yes, Father Clifford conducts services every Sunday morning. You should come. Father Clifford. The sanctuary is in the ship's fore on the upper deck. The good father holds services every Sunday morning. What are you talking about? I'm a man of the cloth. Well, I will be as soon as Father Clifford. Never mind. It doesn't matter what Angela thinks. Soon I will take vows of chastity. Father Clifford says she is my trial, my temptation. I must choose between her and the church. I have chosen the church. God.
Maybe one.
I am Father Clifford of St. Monica's Church. She is the patron saint of lost children, very popular among the faithful of Rivet City. I'm surprised you've never heard of her. If you want to hear her story, it will be the topic of my sermon on Sunday. Services begin at 8 a.m. You should come.
Evil.
What? If that's true, I'll defrock him. Not only is he fornicating, but he's doing it with such an innocent young girl. Ah, Diego! What have you done? He has forced my hand. I cannot let him be a priest now. This may be the end of the faith if I cannot find another acolyte.
Saint Mon- Wahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahah
ship's water isn't much better. If we don't get fresh water soon, we'll all end up like that. Evening. God bless you and keep you safe. Father Clifford accused me of having relations with Angela. He wouldn't listen when I told him it was a lie. I am no longer an acolyte. I've been expelled. Sometimes when God shuts one door, though, he opens another. I've asked Angela to marry me, and she said yes.
Oh, shit.
You're a petty criminal, but I'm willing to give you a chance.
Same here, bro. Wait, which one of these fuckers is the synth, and how do I figure it out? Particular doctor, a fucking speech. Let me come back. How do I get out of here? Purification plant. Father! There's no psychos I can do for doing this, because that's not. DLCs, I won't do this yet. I don't have any more side quests. Just wander the ways. Where the hell is the Brotherhood at? Oh, bro, map here. I've discovered nothing. I've gone nowhere. What the fuck do I go out here? And go. That way? Is there a bridge? Okay, I'm just gonna find this main road and wander. Because I wanna unlock some crates. Explore this fucking game, damn it.
Oh shit, oh, what is that? What is happening over here? What? Are those turrets? People's Republic of America? Is that, oh, is this a Brotherhood of Steel camp? Oh, I swear, oh yes! This is what I'm talking about. Where the fuck's the entrance? Citadel, yes, that's exactly where I wanted to be. So how do I get to the front of the Citadel? Where's the front of the Citadel?
Hello, Capital Wasteland! This is Three Dog!
Yes, coming the Brotherhood.
Loud and proud from Galaxy News Radio. Got lots of stuff
got
going
done
down
dirty in later games, they're so cool.
She wanted the waters of life, free and clean, for any and all. God, ain't that beautiful? But even better, it's finally happened. The water is clean, and hell yeah, it's free. Ow! Just a little patience, children. As I speak, the Brotherhood is working with Rivet City Security to get that fresh water to the wasteland. The caravans are coming.
So just not yet.
Name's Paladin Bane. What do you need, civilian? I could see you're trying to appeal to my good nature. Pity for you, I don't have one. I'll give you this one for free. We use our big guns to kill big super mutants, so people like you can sleep at night. Of course. But you'd have to secure the permission of Elder Lions and, well, I just don't see that happening. You're standing in front of the Citadel, headquarters to the Brotherhood of Steel, Capital Wasteland Detachment. Negative. No super mutants, civilians, or traveling salesmen allowed. Yeah, the city ruins are crawling with them. They've pretty much overrun all of old DC. Do yourself and us a favor and stay as far away from there as humanly possible. Definitely no place for civilians.
Okay. So I told you about James, the guy from the vault. And then I told you somebody else crawled out of there too. Right. Well, guess
what?
Who came
how do I get
to
in?
Old Three Dog at his luxurious studio in beautiful downtown DC. That's right, the other vault dweller. Now, you want to know if it gets better, don't you? Well, hell yes, it gets better. Turns out vault dweller number two was none other than James's kid. I know, I couldn't make
this shit up. Okay, but now it gets kind of sad. You see, the kid is looking for his dad. Looking for James. See, James left Vault 101 without telling the kid why. Now, I've since learned that James is a scientist and is working on something big. Is that why he left the vault? Looks that way. So who knows, maybe James is going to save the world. Can't think of a better cause than that. But James, if you're listening, your kid's out, man. And he misses you. So you might want to find him before he gets swallowed up and spit out. And for all you other cats out there listening, if you see the kid from Vault 101 out there, give him a pat on the back and wish him luck. Until next time, this is Three Dog, and you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, bringing you the truth, no matter how bad it hurts. Now, some music.
Serpentine.
Oh!
You're shooting me, that's not nice. Look at me. And then I put a second. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Boom! Oh. Ow, that hurts. Speaking of that, I bought armor, I never equipped it. Hell yeah, crazy people.
Oh!
Need that. Yeah, I think that helped me save the enemy. Yeah, that reader pieces everywhere. Can't tell which one's which. Is that feasible?
saved in a while. Quick saving. This isn't going right either. Fuck. I just want to go that way. Station.
I'm as horny as Kansas in August, high as a flag on the 4th of July. If you'll excuse an expression I use, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love.
Flooded metro. That doesn't sound fun. I'll save that for later. What's the shit right here? I see a green marker. Captain Paglia, Dark Side Barn Grill.
Well, look at this. We got us a wanderer all the way out here in Broom's Wharf. You must got some important business out here to be wandering around, but tain't none of my beeswax what you're doing. But if you're interested in trading, maybe we can help each other. My boys are hunting lurks. Finest meat you could get, but he don't move around in your stomach like Mole Rat does. Right dangerous, those things. Just as soon take your head off as look at you. Watch yourself out here. They're all over. Some fellas came out here a while ago that said they was looking for some do-gooder that came out from one of them vaults. I told them I ain't seen nobody like that and sent them on their way. They might still be around here, though, if you think you can help them. They've recently stepped up patrols in the downtown D.C. ruins in response to increasing sightings of everybody's favorite freaks, the super mutants.
Without our buddies from the Brotherhood, I'm guessing the entire Capital Wasteland would have been overrun a long time ago. So if you see a knight or a paladin out there fighting your battles for you, give him a big thanks. Or even better, some ammo. Until next time, this is Three Dog, ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, bringing you the truth, no matter how bad it hurts. And now, some music.
God damn it. Welcome to Greedy. Oh, fuck. Oh, no. I do not like this. Oh, God.
God, my shotgun does nothing to these fucking things. Jesus. Oh, I do not like Grey Ditch. No, oh, I just wasted a fucking stuff, boy. God damn it. Oh, and I dropped my mines, didn't I? I sold them. As we can with stealth, and then we'll worry about stealth as I feel. So all my shotgun ammo doing this. Oh no, oh no. Back the fuck up. Oh god, she fell. Oof. Where's this station go? Marigold station. Mr. Pickles, you are here. Marigold, there's a Foss Church, Franklin, Moment Moon, Empty Islands, Atomic. Abernathy? Great, it's just about cleared. Oh, there's a bunch of buildings I haven't searched. Ha ha!
Okay, okay, we're sweeping and clearing. Oh god, that's two. Okay. Oh god, did it just break? No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Oh, I'm gonna take me the time, this is good. Oh, fuck. This is not the ejection against those. The greed is just fucking red. Oh Jesus, I didn't even see that one. Fucking pay attention. Town seriously gotta be running out of ants by now.
Apocalyptia today. You're listening to the adventures of me, Herbert Daring Dashwood, and my stalwart ghoul manservant Argyle. Today's episode, Escape from Paradise Falls. So, little faith boss, I could disarm this slaver junk with my eyes closed. One second. There, now for yours. Stand still. Argyle, you magnificent bastard! You did it! Don't thank me yet, boss. We still need to get out of here. Let's go, while the guard's away from the front gate. Not so fast, my flesh-rotten friend. That girl we came in with, we're the only chance she's got. Come on!
Oh, God!
All right, she's locked in there. They'd call it the box. First, we need to remove that guard.
Oh god, oh god, why am I getting surrounded? I've been clearing this. Why are there so many left?
Now the door. Child's play, boss. Okay, lady, you're rescued. Now let's get out of... What? Boss? Chumps. Nobody escapes from Paradise Falls. Now let's move back to the pen nice and slow before...
All right. I busted out of that box and was almost home free when I noticed your predicament.
Wait a minute. We do the rescuing around here, sister. Now, now, Argyle. No need to be hasty. We owe this young lady our thanks, Miss...
Penelope Chase, Fortune Hunter. You can buy me a beer later. Now let's cut this shindig short and get the bloody hell out of here. Come on.
Argyle, old friend, I think I'm in love.
Okay. Is that another one?
Be sure and tune in next time for another exciting adventure of me, Herbert Daring Dashwood, and my stalwart ghoul manservant, Arthur.
beautiful. Dude, this gotta be every inn. I like looped the town. It's bullshit, there were so many. Towns have gotta be sanitized. What's a stupid little kid? Your family's dead, but they've been avenged. Where are you, child? Another one? I cleared this street already. Are they respawning? Jesus, they've gotta be respawning. You're 100% respawning. But even. Oh yes, little kid in this shelter. Don't care, leaving, clear the town. Best as I could. Better dead than red.
There's nothing in life but you.
Good fucking dogs.
I never regret the years I'm giving. There is this to give. When you're in love, I'm happy to do whatever I do for you.
Adventures of Captain Cosmos.
There's nothing in life but you.
Set co-starring Jangles the Moon Monkey. Jangles! Ooh, there's boxes. And only hips. Oh, come on, cocktease. Oh shit, wait, are you friendlies?
Well now, if it isn't the little villain from the vault. We've been looking for you. Someone's put quite a price on your head.
Oh, it's my bad karma.
What? You think you can walk around the wasteland doing the evil that you do, and there isn't gonna be something?
Yes, my character's evil.
And now it's time.
My for character's
you
evil, but
to die.
Shit, not to fight them.
Ha ha! No. No, I don't think so.
Okay, bye. Has someone that come after me forever? Oh god! They are shredding me. Oh my god. No time for this shit. Oh, sweet baby Jesus, you two fight. Oh my god. Shotgun. No, no, get back here, bitch. Come here, come here. Karma, they attacked me and didn't want to talk. So that's just. Oh, no, I'm evil. This is even paper. Fuck it.
Nifty America, it's me, your president.
Nice lockpick.
Gotcha! Three dog here. How's everyone doing? And here's me with the news. According to reports from the ever so hoity-toity Tenpenny Tower, a group of displaced ghouls have been trying to gain entrance. Ah, but Lush at Large, Alistair Tenpenny says, no zombies, no how. Come on, Al, cut the ghoulies a break. If they've got the caps and you've got the space, it's a win-win, right? What do you say?
Whoa.
Until next time, this is 3
Oh, neutral, fuck that.
And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, bringing you the truth.
Oh.
No matter how bad it hurts. Time once again for an important GNR public service announcement. Don't feed the Yaogwai, that is all. Now, some music.
The roads are the dustiest, the winds are the gustiest, the gates are the rustiest, the thighs are the crustiest. The song's the lustiest, the friend's the trustiest way.
Damn, these dudes. Oh,
the dogs are the yappiest, the kids are the scrappiest, the jokes the snappiest, the folks the happiest way back home. Don't know why I left the I really must confess, I'm a weary exile, singing my song of loneliness. The grass is the springiest, the bees are the stingiest, the birds
Oh, that was from increasing my stats in this. This has got deadlier because I bumped my stats up a shit ton. Holy fuck. Yes! I needed more juice. That's what I needed that level for. Fuck yeah. Just testing on more rat. You got the shot mode? That feels good. The grins are funniest, smiles the sunniest way back home. Shit, mini break, I gotta go pee. Okay. All right, let's go. Wasteland domination. This is going to be a cocktail steal. Why were they even placed though? If there's so much of a game. Ooh, these are cards. Okay. I'll take it. Hell yeah, repair piece by one, let's go. Fuck, I'm running out of shotgun ammo. I bought like 120 rounds at the frickin' Rivet City.
you, child. You just stole a child murdering body of you. What's happening?
You're new here, aren't you? Wow. I've never got a chance to talk to the new people. Dad always takes care of them before I get a chance. It's okay, I guess. There aren't a lot of kids around here, and no one who comes to visit stays around long. Dad says it could be worse, that there are a lot of starving kids in other places. But still, I wish I had more kids to play with. The same things that all parents do. My mom cooks and cleans the house, and my dad goes to work with Mr. Wilson. They work in the basement, or sometimes in Mr. Wilson's shed. Dad says that when I'm older, I'll come to work with him and learn the family business. It's swell, except I wish there were more kids, and my dad says I'm gonna have to marry smelly old Jenny Wilson someday. He keeps saying stuff to my mom about keeping the family going and how when him and Mr. Wilson were brothers, they didn't want to get married. It's weird. That means Mr. Wilson is my uncle and Jenny is something. I don't know. It seems weird to marry her.
You incest is not incest, opposed to apocalypse. Hello, post-apocalyptic CPS. And you must be smelly Jenny Wilson, you stinky incest bitch. Kill your parents, leave you orphaned. That'd be the most evil.
Why, hello there. I heard there was someone new coming. How can our little family help you? Are you joking? It's fantastic here. The best town in the USA. Has been for, why, it's been so many years running that I've lost count. Oh, well, no one ever asks me my opinion about anything, but I love it here.
Well, hello. Shitter's clogged.
Well, hi there. Welcome to Andale. I'm Willie Wilson, though folks just call me Bill. Is there anything I can do for you? I feed my family, and I love my wife and daughter. What else more is there to life, stranger? Family first. And any man who says anything different is saying something wrong. And you should hit that man with a stick. Why, it's a place to settle down and raise a family. Of course, we don't just let anyone in here. The Homeowners Association is very clear on that. Besides, there's no room, as amazing as Andale is. Is it any wonder that all the houses would be full of happy families?
Well, something here's weird, Bucky. It's only two houses in the whole town.
There are, of course, the Raiders.
What kind of a cult?
Well, hello. Welcome to Andale, winner of the Best Town in the USA contest. Well, I don't right know. But we're the best one. Isn't that what matters? I mean, we're the winners. Us. Not Springfield. Not Rockville. Us. So like I was saying, welcome to Andale. What can the Smith family do for you? It's the best little town there is. We don't have a care in the world here. I mean, I really look
for a couple of costume kooks have been battling.
Good to see you. Hello there, stranger. Good to meet you. Name's Jack Smith. I hear you've already met my wife. Sweet lady, isn't she? But anyway, welcome to Andale, the best little town in Virginia. Not here. Not in Andale. No, sir. The great Commonwealth of Virginia is alive and well. In fact, we just voted ourselves a new governor. The adults walked right on down to the polling location and dropped ballots into the box. How do you think it works? Yes, sir. It's every American's civic duty to cast his vote for his favorite Republican candidate. Am I right? Yes, sir. Democracy is God's best gift. Right after family, of course. Now, my vote is my business and no one else's. But I'll tell you one thing. We didn't vote for any beatnik liberal commies, that's for sure. And it's good to meet you, too. Feel free to stay in Andale as long as you like. Heck, stop by the house for dinner sometime if you'd like. Just let Linda know beforehand so she can make enough for four. Suit yourself, but you... Linda's meatloaf is the best in the country, and her mincemeat pie has won first prize at the town fair 3 years running. But the invitation still stands if you ever change your mind. But listen to me, go on. Did you need something else?
Where should go, y'all? So I can just kill Ace Monkey. This bitch might even a combat knife? She got a jet, she got a shiv, is it? Okay, so what do they do in the basement? A torture chamber, a sex dungeon. Cult. Fucking a chicken down there with the ghoul. Where's their shed? That looks like their mad scientist gay sex lab.
Anything goes. When the Mrs. Ned McLean, God bless her, can get Russian red to yes, then I suppose.
What? What? How? How did you get in here? What are you doing in this town? Get out! Get out while you can! What's wrong? You don't see anything wrong with a quiet little town full of friendly people in the middle of a blasted wasteland? No. Well, yes. But it's all a trick. Don't you know anything? Did you just crawl out of a vault or something? Just about everyone in the wasteland knows to avoid Andale, and they're right to do it. People wander in here, and they don't wander back out. You should. Otherwise, what? You don't believe me? Just look in the basements or out in the shed. Get out. Get
anything goes. When you hear that lady mental standing up, now does the hand thing landing up on her toes.
Ah, they're cannibals.
Anything goes.
Got it.
Just think of those shots you got.
Is that yours?
Locked very hard, so I have to kill him to get it. So, how do they try to kill me? If I eat their food, do I go to sleep? Is that what happens? Let's find out.
Well, hello. I'm so happy to see you. What? Has he been spreading his stories again? Poor guy. I'll just have to have Jack give him a talking to.
Oh no, did I just kill that old man?
Hey there, good to see you again. Oh, old man Harris? Don't mind him. He's gone, you know, a little soft in his later years. Ever since Gladys died, he just hasn't been the same.
And you ate Gladys?
Did he now? I've talked to him about spreading rumors. I guess I'll just have to have another little chat with him. Every time he does this, he scares our new friends off, and we love people. It's a shame when they slip out of our grubby little paws. I work to feed my family just like every... Why, a man that can't keep his family fed isn't any kind of man at all. No, sir. Andale, greatest... Yeah, well, he's hit it rough. Ever since his wife died, he just hasn't been enthusiastic. He stays locked up in his house all day, and the girls bring him his meals. He barely eats enough to stay alive. Poor guy. He's all skin and bones.
The lies pictures that the newsreel takes of me.
So, bongo, 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 he don't wanna leave the Congo.
So what do I do? What's the plan?
I
do, I know I got signs for the key guy. Oh god, did he go talk to the old man?
Don't want no
penthouse. He didn't use karma, so he came in so bad. So, let's get the key and check.
They hurry to the
kitchen ground.
What do they do, Danny?
They swim and they fish, but that's what I do all year round.
Ah, there it is. Cannibals. He keeps his family fed. Strange meat. Strange meat.
Don't want no jailhouse.
Why I keep my family fed. I'm stealing murder shit. Cannibal shit.
So I think
negative karma for stealing from cannibals, but not for killing them. I'm leaving a little girl and a little boy orphaned. I can't kill the children in the game. Stolen the key. I'm gonna kill him. Oh shit, I am killing him. Oops. Two orphan children that are going to starve on the wasteland. I can't get negative karma for 100 pounds. She's just got a knife. Where's the children? I'm going to talk to the kids. Where's the swimming one?
Hello again. Daddy can help you. I'm just a kid, you know.
Just a kid, you know. Strange meat. Strange meat. Oops, cannibals for days. Okay. Oh, shit. Bitch. So you go into the meat shed?
Hey,
sabotage it and see that.
GNR, Three Dog, all you need to know. What rhymes with shoes and often gives you the blues? That's right, it's time for the cashews. Okay, that doesn't really rhyme. How about news? Man, am I getting sick of this little punk. From Innocent Vault Kid to
Jesus,
Sicko Urban Invader.
Fuck you and your lasers.
Children, you are going to love this. Right. Well, guess who came to visit old Three Dog at his luxurious studio in beautiful downtown DC? That's right, the other vault dweller. Now, you want to know if it gets better, don't you? Well, hell yes, it gets better. Turns out Vault Dweller number 2 was none other than James's kid. I know, I couldn't make this shit up. Okay, but now it gets kind of sad. You see, the kid is looking for his dad. Looking for James. See, James left Vault 101 without telling the kid why. Now, I've since learned that James is a scientist and is working on something big. Is that why he left the vault?
Oh, shit. Oh, fuck.
Three Dog. All you need to know. What rhymes with shoes and often gives you the blues? That's right. It's time for the cashews. Okay, that doesn't really rhyme. How about news? Man, am I getting sick of this little punk. From Innocent Vault Kid to Sicko Urban Invader, here's the latest. Ooh, boy, children, you are going to love this. Okay, so I told you about James, the guy from the vault. And then I told you somebody else crawled out of there too. Right. Well, guess who came to visit old Three Dog at his luxurious studio in beautiful downtown DC? That's right, the other vault dweller. Well, hell yes, it gets better. Turns out Vault Dweller number 2 was none other than James's kid. I know, I couldn't make this shit up. Okay, but.
Oh shit.
Kind of sad. Looking for James. Why? Now I've since learned that James is a scientist and is working on something big. Is that why he left the vault? Looks that way. So who knows? Maybe James is going to save the world. Can't think of a better cause than that. But James, if you're listening, your kid's out, man, and he misses you. So I want to find him and swallow him. And for all you other cats out there listening, if you see the kid from Vault 101 out there, give him a pat on the back and wish him luck. Until next time, this is Three Dog, ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, bringing you the truth. No matter how bad it hurts. And now a super important public service announcement. We all know the dangers of radiation, but with the right precautions, you can prevent accidents.
Ooh, they're shut. Oh God! Oh, there's that.
To know. this little punk. From innocent Vault Kid to sicko urban invader, here's the latest.
Ooh, boy! Children, you are going to love this.
Okay. Oh my God.
So I told you about James, the guy from the vault.
No.
Okay, then.
Downtown DC.
That's
right, the other vault dweller.
I don't even think I shot or did that.
You want to know if it gets better, don't you? Well, hell yes, it gets better. Turns out vault dweller number two was none other than James's kid. I know, I couldn't make this shit up. Hey, but now it gets kind of sad. You see, the kid is looking for his dad.
Good God.
Looking for James. Left Vault 101 without telling the kid why. Now, I've since learned that James is a scientist and is working on something big. Is that why he left the vault? Looks that way. So who knows? Maybe James is going to save the world. Can't think of a better cause than that. But James, if you're listening, your kid's out, man, and he misses you. So you might want to find him before he gets swallowed up and spit out. And for all you other cats out there listening, if you see the kid from Vault 101 out there, give him a pat on the back and wish him luck. Until next time, this is 3Dog! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, bringing you the truth, no matter how bad it hurts. And now, a super important public service announcement. We all know the dangers of radiation, but with the right precautions, you can prevent actual death or even... Keep your eyes on those Geiger counters, kids. Tick, tick, tickety means run your ass out of there, and then pop some right away for good measure. If you do need to head into the heat, be smart. Give yourself a nice boost of Rad-X first.
Remember, let's just see what happens. Oh, God. Did the bear kill the scorpion? Okay, cool. Kill the jaguar. Okay. Why would it just explode it over here? Oh, is that Tenpenny Tower?
No other will do. I've lost all ambition. The world is in vain. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same. I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me,
I have to blow up Megaton.
Set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in
your
heart.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to stop a great big flame down in your heart. You see, way down inside of me, darling, I have only one desire. That one desire is you.
And get results.
Nobody else ain't gonna do it.
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim.
Here we go, Tenpenny Tower, let's go.
You can tell Tenpenny he can kill.
kiss my ass. You've got plenty of bottle caps. Let me in, goddammit.
How many times do we have to go through this? You're not getting in.
I can stand here all day yelling at you through this damn speaker if I have to.
I've already told you Tenpenny won't allow zombies to live here.
Who the hell are you calling a zombie?
You're definitely not. That's for damn sure. For the last time, no zombies allowed.
Can't you tell the difference between me and a feral? Fine. I'll show you the goddamn difference. Just you wait. You'll get... What are you looking at?
I'll steal these bits.
I thought I told you to get the hell out of here. Tenpenny doesn't want your goddamn caps. And I don't... For the last time, get your... What? No, just those damn ghoul. Ghoul or not, I must inform you that you were trapped... That's it. Just a minute. Let's not be hasty. If Tenpenny is interested in what you have to say, I suppose you should get your chance. Though he normally conducts all his business through Mr. Burke. If Tenpenny doesn't want to talk to you, then you best leave him alone. If you bother Mr. Tenpenny or any of his residents, I will be very glad to forcibly show you out. Do we understand each other? Good. Welcome to Tenpenny Tower. Don't do anything stupid.
Maybe you beg of me when you are all alone. Maybe the one who
periscopes, I can go blow up many times.
Waiting for you.
Yes.
We'll prove
hey.
You got something to say? That damn Roy Phillips won't take no for an answer. Keep showing up, looking for a handout. He and his kind aren't wanted. End of story. If I were a betting man, I'd place a stack of caps on him trying something violent soon. And that would make Tenpenny nervous. I don't like it when Tenpenny gets nervous. But I can't spare the manpower to go hunt down Roy Phillips and his band of You serious? You don't know what a ghoul is? A goddamn disaster waiting to happen, that's what they are. Sure, maybe you can get over the fact that they look like someone took a cheese grater to their face. But it's what you don't see that's the problem. The radiation slowly eats away their brain. Then they go zombie on you. It's better for everyone to kill them before all that, if you ask me. Really? You? You're welcome to give it a try. But don't come crying to me when you get hurt. They've holed up in the nearby metro tunnels. They're living with packs of feral ghouls. Be careful. Roy seems damn close to turning zombie himself. I suppose you won't be doing this out of the kind. How's 500 bottle caps sound? Payable upon...
Oh, yeah.
Listen up good.
We need more speech.
Here, Roy Phillips. It's dark in those tunnels. Shoot first and ask questions.
Here, Roy Phillips is following. Shit, remember? Excess of spectrum.
You having trouble with those ghouls? I guess we...
No, what did I just sell?
Thanks.
Each morning, a missionary of a touch of neon sign. He tells the native population that civilization is dying. And three educated savages holler from a bamboo tree. That civilization is a thing for me to see.
Bongo, 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 I don't wanna leave the Congo. No, 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 no. Bingo, bango, bongo, I'm so happy in the jungle, I refuse to go. Don't want no bright lights, false keys, doorbells, landlords, I make it clear.
That no matter how they coax him,
I'll stay right here. I look through a magazine the missionary's wife concealed.
Alrighty, I think I might call it here. Quick save, let's do a big boy save.
Automobile.
There we go. Alrighty.